know that. How's business for you, brother?
All is well. All is well.
That's good. You know, that's always good to hear.
You said it was your first time doing what now?
A face-to-face talk with you. It's our first time talking face-to-face. So that's good. I got your hat on over here, you know.
Oh, look at that. What you doing with that? Hey, I didn't even know you had you one. Look at you.
Yeah. I remember when I messaged you the first time on Facebook, I'm like, oh, I got to give me one of those hats.
That's right. I be getting leads. People say, you wear that hat. People say, you buy houses. My grandma want to sell, or my auntie want to sell. I've gotten leads from it. That's crazy, ain't it?
Exactly, man. And that's what I'm trying to get from it. But basically, like I told you, this is going to be a quick little interview video from our YouTube, because once you told me what you do, I was fascinated. I mean, finding out that terms could be more powerful than cash, that's crazy, right? So I want to, you know, understand what you do, I guess, if you can just tell the viewers about what it is that you do in the investment world.
So, yeah, so basically what I do is I create creative real estate transactions to help solve people's problems. It's really that simple. I don't really like to categorize as a wholesaler or categorize as any of the titles of fix and flippers and all the other stuff people say. What I do is solve problems for people, you know, make transactions happen that most people can't even see. So, you know, I'm always just trying to find a way that I could provide value and solve a problem for somebody else.
I hear that. And that's the name of the game. Now when you're talking about financing, is it just sub two? Is it like, I don't even know what wraparound mortgage is, right? That's something you brought up to me before. Are you doing seller financing? Like, what are the things that you do?
Yeah, so basically we can do pretty much anything. That's the thing about it. A lot of people get into this real estate space and say, you have to do only what's in this little bitty box right here. Don't look at that other stuff. And it's like, even, you know, and it can go from real estate attorneys, that can go from real estate agents, other real estate investors, wholesalers. Everybody think that you only can do these one or two things. You can do so much stuff. As long as the buyer and the seller agree, you can pretty much do pretty much anything, you know, as long as you structure it right and, you know, you got your paperwork right. Because, you know, your paperwork makes that paperwork. That's the most important thing with real estate in general. People can get in the way. The property can get in the way. Family can get in the way. All type of stuff can mess up a deal. However, when your paperwork's straight, ain't nothing to say. What the paperwork say?
Exactly. Got to abide by that agreement.
That's right.
Oh, man, that's amazing. I mean, I think you hit it right on the head. Once the paperwork, you know, paperwork has to make the paperwork. So I like that a lot. I think I'm really inspired by seeing you doing it, because now I'm seeing a lot more people of color get into it. I mean, real estate is for everybody, right? But the fact that you're another, you know, you're a brother, a person of color, that's very inspirational. How did you get into it? I mean, does your family do this as well? What, you know, gave you this idea to pursue real estate?
Yeah, good question. So really, I'm a serial entrepreneur by trade. I haven't had a job since 2011. So I've dibbled and dabbled and lost money and made money and lost money in Bitcoin and all the other crazy stuff you throw money in out here, trying stuff to see what'll stick. So one day I was actually sitting up watching some videos, you know, motivational videos, things like that. Help you get your mind right. Very important for that. I fell asleep, and when I woke up, it was a guy walking around with a big beard, walking around talking about real estate, named Max Maxwell. That's right. I said, what is he talking about? Wholesaling? What's that? Pull it up on my computer, looked it up. Oh, wow. You can buy houses or do real estate with no money, no credit, just knowing how to structure a deal. So I dabbled into that. I was able to close 17 wholesale deals in my first year. I just actually hit my second year in the business. So I closed my first deal in August of 2018, went on to close 17 wholesale deals. I now have 10 real estate properties that I own myself, and like 2 years in the game. You can't even do that in college. People go to college for longer than that. Don't get, you know what I mean? So I got a saying now, and it's kind of controversial. I've been throwing it out there. I'm seeing if it's going to stick. Drop out of college and go learn real estate. That's how serious this is. Just drop out. I don't care what you study, and go learn real estate, because that stuff is, that's how powerful it is. It can change your life.
So 17 deals in your first year.
Yep. Could have been more. There was so many that didn't make it through, you know, for different title issues or different problems or, you know, heirs problems, you know, just all type of stuff. You know, the business, it's just always going to be something that you can't do. That's why it's so important to keep your marketing going all the time. Keep that pipeline full with more people coming your way saying they want to sell. You may not be able to buy all the houses you come across. You may not be able to help everybody you do come across. However, we want to help as many as humanly possible. So when you stay locked in a box of just wholesaling, you can only beat them down on price. I'll give you $2 for your house. We don't want to do that all the time. I want to give you as much as possible, and I can give you a lot more if you'll take these sweetheart terms, you know, which when I say sweetheart terms, I'm talking little to nothing down, low monthly payments for as long as humanly possible. That's how you really make wealth in real estate long term. Not this fix and flip, not this fixing or get it under contract, flip the wholesale contract. Nothing wrong with that. Don't get me wrong. You can make money, but you won't really get wealthy doing that. And plus, that's a hustle. That's a job. I never got into this business to work another job. Like I said, I haven't had a job since 2011. So working a job isn't for me. I'm about setting up systems, setting up businesses, leveraging people, leveraging software, and making things happen.
Man, that you it feels like I'm doing something wrong over here, bro. You got 17 deals your first year. I mean, that's amazing. So I think you said you're going on your second year or you're going on your third year?
I actually just hit my second year anniversary. So I closed my first deal August 31st of 2018 and what's this August of 2020. So I'm just hitting my 2 year mark into the business. So I'm still new. However, I jumped into both feet, spent money on marketing, spent money on virtual assistants, all that type of stuff that people say, oh, don't do that, man. I'm going in. I know I don't want a cold call one. So why am I going to sit up and act like I'm a cold call when I can pay somebody $4 or $5 an hour to do the same work? Be smart. You know what I mean? Especially when you're getting deals. If you don't have money, I can understand it. Like, oh, I got a small budget and I don't really want to do, you know, you get 2-3 deals under your belt or you got some kind of budget, spend the money, man. Get somebody on your team because real estate is a team sport. And a lot of people forget that.
Yep. So in your first year, what did your team look like? I mean, you said you have VA. So was it you and just one VA? Did you have a caller as well as maybe a spreadsheet VA? What did your team look like?
Good question. Good question. So, yeah. So probably about 2 weeks into marketing, I found that I was going to go ahead and hire a VA. I went on and because I did some cold calling myself and I seen it really wasn't for me and I knew I wasn't going to do it. So I started off with one virtual assistant and now I'm up to four. So I have four now. But basically, yeah, started off with one virtual assistant and me. I did the acquisitions, dispositions, all of the setup. And then I have virtual assistants kind of run most of the business for me. The grunt work stuff, you know, spreadsheets and scrubbing lists and pulling this and, you know, calling people, all that type of stuff. I do more so closing now, but I'm trying to even separate from that. So I get leads come in basically every day. I go back in our Podio system, pull it up, see who wants to sell. And it breaks everything down there. How much they want for the property, condition of the property. You know, basic stuff, you know, would they consider terms? We ask everybody we speak to, would you consider taking a monthly payment until we pay you off in full? Just a question. Some people say yes. Some people say no. Most people say, what is that? If they say, what is that? That's an opportunity to pitch a term creative deal. But some people like, no, I want all cash. Okay. I'm just going to tell you, it's going to be a low ball offer. We ain't going to pay nowhere near retail. Some people don't care. They sign a dotted line. We'll do a wholesale deal. They do a terms deal, we do that. But yeah, basically it's just me and some virtual assistants.
Man, that's great. So when do you, I mean, from going to one to four, that's exponential growth right there. When do you see your business being fully automated?
You know, that's a good question. You know, hopefully this year, you know, this coronavirus kind of messed up a lot of stuff, but you know, we got a lot of deals. We got, I think like 7 deals on the board right now, 7 or 8 deals up. So, you know, we always keep some stuff going because, you know, sometimes stuff don't go through for whatever reason. Sometimes, you know, like I say, issues come up. So if we keep enough people coming in, some will get to the finish line and get that check or some will get to the finish line and get that deed. I'd rather get the deed so I can own that property forever, regardless of the loans, regardless of the debt, regardless of any problems that are on, you know, with the property. I'd rather get the house and keep it long term.
Absolutely. Building that wealth is what it's about. And I know you mentioned before, you know, you got 17 deals the first year, but not all of them made it. Honestly, what was the most difficult part for you to actually keep pushing forward? Like when you got a deal that didn't close, did you get discouraged? Was it just perseverance? What's the biggest thing in your opinion that brought you here today?
Yeah, just reality check. You either going to do this or you're going to go get a job. And I'm unemployable. So it's either you're going to make it work or you're going to go get a job. I ain't getting no job. So I ain't going to the plantation. I know some people do it. I shouldn't say nothing bad about it. And there ain't nothing wrong with having a job. The problem is it's only one flow of income. But as far as your question, yeah, I really the biggest thing It's more so just, pushing through regardless. You know, I know all the deals aren't going to make it. And 17 deals actually closed. So let me make sure you understand what I'm saying. I actually closed 17 deals. We had about, 50, and some didn't make it for whatever reason. And so it's like, sometimes they go through and sometimes they don't. And I just don't worry about it. You know, I'll try to get the ones that can go through and make them get to the finish line. That's all we can do.
Okay, absolutely. Is there, looking back, 2 years ago, and the people who are going to be watching this video, do you have any advice that you would like to give to them?
Yeah, most definitely. Keep the marketing going. Even if you got a bunch of deals, like we got all these deals on the board and new leads come in every day, keep on locking up deals because you don't know who's going to make it. Some won't make it to the finish line. Some have title issues. We just had a deal, for example, last week. We got everything down with the seller. We found a buyer. Come to find out, the seller is on there with his dad, and his dad say he ain't signing nothing on the deed. So we can't even do the deal. So he can't even sell a house, but they got the same name, like a senior and a junior. So I'm like, well, we can, it doesn't look like it when you look. But then we went and started digging. We found out that, and he said, my dad said he's not signing nothing. And, I have to respect his wishes. Therefore, that whole deal just done. We're done. It ain't nothing to do about it. Wash our hands of it. I mean, it was a small deal anyway. It was about $5,000. But, still the point that we can't even do nothing for him after he rushed us to want to buy it. Rushed just to try to make the deal go through, and then he flake out at the last minute. I'm like, my dad ain't signing off. Well, what the heck you trying to sell a house you don't own for? This is the kind of crazy stuff you come across in this business, but it can happen. Sometimes you won't know things until you do that title search, and that's where we found out.
Absolutely, and I think that's kind of speaking to me, man. I've only been in the business for about 9 months, I think going on 10. And one of my biggest downfalls is when I get a good lead or two or three or four, I would stop my marketing. I'm like, I don't need to make those calls. I got 5 leads and then none of them close. I'm like, wow. So and that's exactly. It's a big reality check right there. So I'm definitely still learning that. I'm trying to get myself to, be consistent, stay on it no matter what. Don't count your eggs before they hatch. I think that's the saying. So
that's right. That's right. Keep that chicken right. Cluck, cluck, and cluck. And that's why I had to get the virtual assistants, because they keep the marketing going regardless if I do it or not. Because I do some stuff too. Don't get me wrong. I do some things to try to make sure we keep leads going, networking events, all that type of stuff as well. And just, just being out here doing the game, wheeling and dealing, doing this real estate stuff. So I always try to get, the leads coming in regardless if I'm going to do marketing myself. And that's what you should do. And anybody that's in the business, how can I get a system where leads flow in all the time? And I'm a whisper a place, a secret place for you. You ready for it?
I'm ready.
Craigslist. We still get leads on Craigslist. And they like, Craigslist dead. Keep saying it. Facebook. Let go. Offer up. I've gotten deals off those apps, those little, regular apps. Yes. Yes. All you got to do is look on there. People selling it. They're having yard sales. Sometimes they're selling their house. Sometimes they actually list the house right on there for sale by owner. And you're like, why you don't just list it with a real estate agent? I asked every person that anyway. And they always say, I don't want to pay that commission. Great. So if you sell a house to us, there's no commissions. There's no fees. There's no stuff. I won't charge a dime. So they come close to us. And so, we found deals in all different types of places.
I hear that, man. I got to check that out. Let go and offer up. You've gotten deals from there.
Yeah, I bought a house in South County that came off Let Go. Yeah, it came right off Let Go. I said, wow, he had it right up on there for sale. I just messaged him and then started talking to him and said, yeah, I'm going to come see it. And he ended up doing a deal.
That's amazing, man. Can you, I hope this isn't, a little too personal into your business, but can you tell us about the best or most profitable or enjoyable deal you've gotten in your 2 years of doing the business?
Yeah, most definitely. My best deal was my first creative deal, my first subject to deal, still paying me to this day. That's why I love it, to be honest. So this deal happened in December of 2018. I'm only 4 months or so into the game. So December of 2018, we did a marketing campaign. We actually pulled a list of absentee owners, did a ringless voicemail campaign saying, yeah, we want to buy your house. Just want to know if you were interested in selling. Call us or text us back if you're interested. So a lady texts back, yeah, I want to sell my house, but I don't know if you can buy it because I owe too much on it. So I say, you got time to talk. I can call you later on. She said, yeah, I'll be on lunch at 11:30. Guess where I was at 11:30? On the phone with her, right? So she's like, yeah, telling me a little bit about the house and all this stuff. So basically come to find out, the house is about 3 months behind on payment, about $800 a month. So she owes about $2,400 or so in back payments to get this loan caught up. She had family members living in the house. They left it left the house. Nothing wrong with the house, really. They just left it. So it's a nice house in a good area, 4-bedroom, right here in South County in Afton, St. Louis. So I actually was able to work out a deal with her, bought her house subject to, paid the $2,400 to catch her loan up, about another $1,000 in closing costs. So I got a house worth about $165,000 for about $3,500 out of pocket.
Wow.
So I bought the house subject to. That ain't even the gist. That's just the entry level. So that's first part. That's how I acquired the deal, subject to. So paid about $1,000 in closing costs and paid about another $2,400 or so to catch her loan up. $3,400 out of pocket, right? We got the house. Payments on the house about $750. Actually, at that time, it was $800. It dropped to $750. But right at that time, it was like $800 a month. So I went on and got the deal. I actually marketed the deal to find a tenant buyer or a lease option type person. So this person came along and said, yeah, I want to buy the house. I got $20,000 down. You're approved. We just got to make sure you like the house. So we get him in there. He likes the house. He wants it, right? He gets it. He puts $20,000 down. Remember, I'm only in it for $3,400. So I'm in profit mode right there, right?
Yep.
I'm in profit mode. I put $3,400 in. He gives me $20,000 back to move into my house that I still own to this day on a lease option. He's just a tenant with an option to buy. So he gives $20,000 down. He's paying $1,000 a month. And like I said, at that time, it was $800. But when I switched the insurance and changed it from a non-owner or from an owner-occupied policy to a non-owner-occupied policy, it dropped the price a little bit. So my payments now are like $750 a month. He pays me $1,000 a month. So I make $250 passive cash flow for almost the last 2 years on one house that I ain't got no money in. And I got about 10 of those. That's just the best one. So this gets this and so there's some other moving parts. I know that's a lot. I know you're like, it's a lot of you throwing on me here. Whoa. So like I said, the house I sold it to him for $165,000 full ARV. She only owes now about $115,000. So I got another $50,000 in equity if he ever decides to cash me out. And I get cash flow while I wait. So I don't do any maintenance. I don't do any repairs or anything on their property. So it's just still the goose that keeps on laying those golden eggs.
Man, that makes, I don't know, when I hear about terms in real estate like that, I get chills, man. Things like that are actually possible, and that's what excites me, man. And so for you guys watching, right, if you want to know how to do this, Chris, go ahead and tell the viewers where they can go, your website, social media, to find out about maybe your courses or more information so they could figure out how exactly you do it, man.
Most definitely, most definitely. So I'm one of the easiest people to find. I'm on all social media at ChrisMonroeSTL. That's Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all the social sites, ChrisMonroeSTL. As far as some, if you want some free training, I have over 200 real estate videos available at wokerealestate.com. That's woke, W-O-K-E, wokerealestate.com. That's the website. Got all these videos on there. You can get contracts on there to do any type of deal, whether it's a wraparound mortgage subject to, lease option, seller finance, any type of deal you want to do, wholesaling. And most of my systems are set up to be virtual. A lot of the houses I bought and sold and done deals with, I never met the seller. I never met the buyer. And sometimes I never even went to the house. So, I mean, it just shows you what's possible. I mean, it still blows me away to this day that you can sit at your computer desk and get a check wired into you in a couple of weeks. It's crazy. So wokerealestate.com, that's the website to find out more.
Man, for sure, guys. It'll be in the description. Go ahead and look. I'll put all this information, social media, website, contact, all that good stuff. And Chris, before we wrap this up, one last question, man. In 10 years, where do you see yourself, your business, your family? What's your goal 10 years from now?
10 years is a long way away. And if I can accomplish so much in 2 years, 10 years, oh, man, I would say at least 50 doors. That's what I would like to be, you know, because that's the thing. That's the name of the game. Passive cash flow. You can work, hustle, grind for the rest of your life. Gray hairs can come in and everything. And you'd be like, oh, man, and you never get to retire. I'm trying to retire like in a year or two, to be honest. I'm already semi-retired because I haven't had a job in years, like I say. But I do have several businesses. So I do have a whole store here. I'm actually in and out. We have a store. We sell furniture, collectibles, antiques, all type of stuff. I'm also a licensed auctioneer. So 25 and 35 and 45 and I sold. We sell stuff like so you know, I'm a jack of many trades, but I don't try to do too many things. I like to set up good systems, get people on the team, make money, help a lot of people out. And so 10 years from now, I mean, I don't even have an idea. I mean, that seems so far away. But I know in the near future, for sure, my goal right now is 30 doors. By that time, I should have at least 50. So I do want to stay in real estate for sure, because I haven't even scratched the surface. I've done a lot in this short amount of time, but there's so much more I haven't done. Mobile homes, apartment buildings, Airbnb, VRBO, all this different stuff you can do. I mean, this game is so wide open. Land, development, building, construction. I mean, that stuff is so much. I don't even fix on houses, by the way. On all those houses I have never did any fix and flips. I do not repair property at all. That's what kind of drew me to this thing with wholesaling and even with the creative deals, because I do not fix houses. A lot of people want to get in and fix and flip. And that stuff is costly entanglements. And I try not to get into that. I try to get into stuff to where I can get in, get my money, and collect checks like Bank of America. I don't have to worry about tenants, toilets, termites, trouble, or any of the other T's you can come up with at this time.
Yep, I hear you in and you out, man. Quick money. Well, probably not quick, but it's less intensive, I guess you can say. So that's honestly it. That wraps up the discussion, man. It was a pleasure getting to, you know, swap a few words with you. I'm fascinated. I'm going to go ahead and visit your website again. I checked it out the first time, but I think I got to go back.
We updated. We updated all the time. So it's always updated content, updated videos, interviews, different things like that. We put stuff out. I put out a lot of content. So a lot of people say, I want to get started. There's no excuse these days. This is the information age. Get on that internet, bang those videos out. Like I said, I got over 200 plus myself. So if you just go watch all them, you'll learn the whole game right there. I do seller calls right on the phone with sellers, buyers calls. If I need to wrap up a buyer, lock them up, all that stuff's right on the website, wokerealestate.com. And it makes it easy. You know, it's like, it shows you in real time versus, oh yeah, I'm going to tell you the story. No, go through the deal. Walk with me through the deal. And we also have a free Facebook group as well called Woke Real Estate Investing on Facebook. So, you know, networking with like-minded people, that's the biggest thing, you know. And to add to what you asked me earlier, that's another thing. Get around some like-minded people. Get around some killers. Get around some soldiers. Get around some people that's making some deals, because, you know, you hang around five bums, you'll be the sixth. You don't want to be that. Show me your friends and I'll show you your future. So you definitely want to get around some like-minded people that's going to elevate you and pull you up. You don't want to be the smartest person in the room, but, you know, it's always something out here that you can learn. A fool could tell you something you didn't know.
Exactly, man. You guys want knowledge. You guys want information. You want merch. Head over to wholesalers.com. Chris, it was a pleasure, man. Keep killing it. I'll be just like you one day, brother. It was a great call, though, man. I thank you for giving me your time, and keep doing what you're doing.
For sure. Thank you. Appreciate you. You have a good day.
You too, sir. Thank you.
Bye-bye.